Hi, I am Blaise from SynthMorph. Today I will talk about Zebralette, which is a great little free VST instrument from Yuhe, a cut-down version of their flagship Zebra 2 synthesizer. Despite of the fact that several components were removed, I always liked it from the first moment I started using, and here is why. First, it employs single window interface where you can inspect and edit all the settings of a sound within seconds, except the effect settings here, but that's also a click away. What's more, it's resizable between 70 and 200%, so you can optimize it to the size of your computer display. Next, it's serious stuff. Despite the relatively simple structure, it's deep instrument sound-wise, by offering enough constraints that allow you to focus tightly on making great presets. And in my experience, this is quite a unique synthesizer because its simplicity and constraints remove the chance of overcomplicating the sound design process. So to sum it up, limitations makes you creative. You may feel this after working with Zebralette for some time. Its strength lies in the single, very flexible digital oscillator, the spectral FX timbral modifiers, together with its wavetable capabilities, makes it a cute little zebra. As we have a rather limited filter, his Zebralette may not be your first choice for ordinary subtractive analog patches. It can even be if you want. But it delivers the digital character resembling the typical wavetable sound, similar to PPG, Waldorf Microwave series, while opening literally unlimited ways for musical explorations through its custom waveforms. So you are not limited at all in terms of sound sources. I decided to make this video to help you to avoid some of the difficulties I faced when worked with Zebralette for the first time, and giving you some short tips to help designing patches for this BB Zebra. Okay, let's see. So, tip number one, layer multiple instances. The Big Zebra 2 has four times all the major sections, like four times the oscillators, FM oscillators, envelopes, mixers, plus arpeggiator, much more effects, XY pads, and so on. While the single oscillator Zebralette is not really comparable to the Zebra 2 alone, it can still deliver the more complex type of sound of Zebra 2. Just try to imitate the composite patches of Zebra by layering multiple Zebralette instances in your DAW and playing unisono, getting some absolutely gorgeous layers. Check the video on the blog page for some sound examples. Okay, tip number two, filtering without a filter. Firstly, there is no dedicated filter in Zebralette, but using the spectral FX called filter, you can simulate low-pass, high-pass filter. Modulate the filter with an MSEG. This is the abbreviation of the versatile multi-segment envelope generator. And you will have a complete filter with its corresponding filter envelope. Secondly, while technically it's not a filter, but you can also simulate the continuous change of overtone content by sweeping through the different waves using the wave editor, C-tip 5. This is a kind of pseudo-filtering, sounds like a filter, but it's wavetable synthesis actually. Tip 3. Use micro-modulations. You can modulate 10 parameters with all the possible modulation sources. It's always worth to apply a very tiny amount of modulation to any of these destinations. Using the shift and the mouse scroll wheel, you can set extremely small amount of modulations, what you do not necessarily hear, but it adds subtle change or movement that makes the sound more alive. Here is an example, just listen to the same preset with the same setting, only with some added micro modulations. So here is the first one, no micro modulations. And now let's check with the micro-modulations as well. As you hear, the difference is quite remarkable. The first one is rather static, while the second one is much more living and organic. Next tip, tip 4, parameter lock. It's a semi-random but fast sound design technique to create presets that keep the essential of the original root sound. It means that you can lock certain parameters that will be kept intact when browsing through the presets, while all other unlocked parameters values will be updated from the new preset. So here is an example. Here is the basic patch we'll be using as a source for the parameter lock. You see, this one, this MSEG curve modulates the pitch. So if we want to transfer this kind of attribute to another sound, we have to lock this. This one, and this one, and this one, these three. You see, so you get the same kind of vibe when browsing. Tip number 5, generate transitions between waveforms. It's about the oscillator of Zebralette, and there are two kinds of morph modes and two kinds of blend modes to change the oscillator over time. If you're really interested in what's the difference between these modes, read it in the manual. But the main point is, geomorph and spectromorph, these are morphing shapes defined by nodes or points, call it whatever you like. And these points can morph from this state to that state. Geoblend and spectroblend. Well, you don't see nodes here. Instead, you can draw or import wavetables with different harmonic content. It's not a real morph. It just blends between the shapes, so probably crossfades between the different waveforms. The cool thing is that at both the morph and blend modes, you can generate transitions by selecting any waveform in the wave selector, then press Alt or Command and click to a different wave. It will create transitions depending on the oscillator mode. Tip 6. Disable loop in MSEG, really. The multi-segment envelope generator MSEG allows you to loop between the set nodes. Sometimes you don't want any looping. Unfortunately, the phrasing of the manual is a bit cloudy on how to achieve this. To make it short, you cannot switch off the loop or get rid of it, but you can essentially deactivate its effect. The fastest way is to drag the left or the right part of the bar range and move them to the same point one after each other. Loop has gone. If you are doing it exactly at the last point, then it will be an exact one-shot envelope. Technically, it's still looping the very last segment of the envelope, but you don't hear it, and this is what you want. Another thing here is the pointer. Sometimes you may not see this pointer moving. It animates the pointer only if you assign an MSEG as a source modulator to any destination, and at the same time, you right-click and pointer animation is set to coarse or fine. If any of these two are missing, the pointer will not animate, so check these two things in this case. Number 7. get the most out of the few LFOs. Compared to Zebra 2, which has something like 6 LFOs, we will find only 2 LFOs in Zebralette. One is the LFO G1, which is a global LFO. It means it's monophonic and it impacts all played voices simultaneously. The LFO 1 is a polyphonic LFO and it affects per voice. If you want, you can change this LFO to monophonic as well. Just set the restart to single and it becomes monophonic. It's possible if you run out of the two LFOs, you can convert the MSEG into a third LFO by drawing a basic waveform like sine, pulse, triangle, and set it to a full length loop. Here is an example of the triangle MSEG waveform modulating the main pitch. Behaves like an LFO. It's not really musical yet, so make it faster by applying the half size option multiple times and fine tune the modulation amount. To create vibrato, it's very easy because it's built in at the tune section. There is the vibrato LFO 1 amount. To get a proper vibrato, set it like this. The other thing, the tremolo, by rhythmically modulating the volume, set the volume mod to any LFO or the MSEG with a rhythmic looping waveform. Tip 8. Bipolar modulation with MSEG. The MSEG, this one, the multi-segment envelope generator, is usually used as a unipolar modulator, which means here that it sends modulation values only to the positive direction. But with a little trick, it's possible to use it as a bipolar modulator as well, which means that it sends modulation to both positive and negative directions. Here is a simple example where I will modulate the pitch. So here are the steps. First, set the oscillator tune to -3. Now set the pitch modulation to MSEG and double the amount of the tune, which was here -3, but now with the opposite sign. So 2 times 3 results 6. Why 6? Just observe the relationship. From the middle, here the pitch goes up 3 and down 3. So the whole range is 6. It sounds like this. Now, following the same principle, try with like -18. For the oscillator tune, so the transposing it down to -18 semitones, and enter 36 for the modulation amount. It works the same, but the result is a more extreme pitch bend. Okay, now let's see how to set up this MSEG.
Just right-click on the MSEG area and select the value snap 12.
Actually, this is the vertical snapping. It means that it divides the vertical range to 12 equal spaces. I mean, numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. The other one, the unit snap, is the horizontal snapping, which we don't need right now. Now, put the first and the last MSEG node right to the middle at position 6 of vertical range. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Also this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
to have a symmetric orientation. So this one, and especially the last one, should be centered and not moving vertically at all. Otherwise, it will change the final pitch. Okay, it's not very musical in this form, so let's just use this half-size option multiple times, and you will hear this little scream at the beginning of the sound. It is probably a good idea if you save it as an MSEG preset, so you can reuse it later very quickly without any setup steps, and manipulate only the nodes in between. Also select the right edit mode, like switching on this draw mode, which restricts movement to vertical only, without touching this last point, which is important as it has to arrive back to the right original pitch in case of a harmonic sound. Now we have a nice pitch modulating envelope which bends the pitch not just up or down, but up and down at the same time.
Tip number 9. Ways to get stereo width. If you want to make a wide sound in Zebralette, you can achieve it at several levels. At oscillator level, VCA section width setting. But it only works if you set the stacking modes to dual, quad or 11. At higher level in the synth hierarchy, just try any of the modulation effects like the chorus, forus and phaser. All this creates a nice moving sound in the stereo field. Finally, any of these delays, while the pan part set to off-center, creates subtle stereo movements. Tip number 10. Create your own Zebralette skin. It seems that most US synths come with a flexible skin system with a built-in editor, so you could make your own. These are the steps to activate the internal editor. 1. In a basic text editor like Notepad, create an empty text file. 2. Insert the single line proclamation mark editor equal yes. This is all. 3. Save it under the name default.h2p. 4. Copy this file into the main preset folder of Zebralette. 5. Create a project in your DAW and load a new Zebralette instance. And 6. Now when you open the synth interface, it will appear with an activated editor inside. Now you can select elements, move, resize, use the right click over any element or outside of the main interface, and you get a list of possible functions. But the problem is that this editor has no documentation. So if you have enough time to reverse engineer it through some trial and error, then feel free to experiment. Also, there are some skins available for download from your website or vsdskins.com. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Hopefully some of these tips will help you to avoid problems and spend some more creative time with Zebralette. If you're looking for more tips, just visit my website synthmorph.com. If you have any question or comment, just enter it below. Also, if you find it useful, please subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow me on Facebook via the links listed here. Have a nice day.